Hello, so welcome to the new session of online Neo Institute Yoga classes. My name is Shankar. Okay, so we are doing a sequence called Explore Yoga. So it's a program, 5 days program, to 1 hour 15 minutes each day in the mornings. So let's see. See, exploring is yoga has lot of options. So many different types. Only in asana and pranayama meditation framework. Apart, yoga itself is much huge. So five new things to explore. So we are done explore yoga one, which is very nice. Second, which is we'll see. Okay. So what I'm going to cover in these five things, first. I would say namaskars. So everybody knows Surya Namaskar. So I don't want to talk more about it. So it's all so many people does it, Surya Namaskar. But you know, there are a lot of forms of namaskars. So namaskars is a flow in Vinyasa Yoga, but there are a lot of forms. So what are the, we'll take up some simple form which is known to people, like Vinyasa Yoga, A, B, normal Surya Namaskar, 10 step, 12 step, and then which I have done some new modifications, and then the desktop chair Surya Namaskar, and then the jumping Surya Namaskar, and then what I do separately, like one Namaskar, but you do it for long time, each pose, and you do it for long time, like 30 minutes and all, it has different effect. So that we will, one session we'll just analyze different forms of namaskars, right? Then second, what do I want to do is called Shakti Vikasaka. So generally everybody knows Sukshma Vyayam. Sukshma Vyayam is the gently touching all the joints, right? But same thing, all the joints can be activated with force also, little. With little vigorously, if you do Shakti, when you do, the effect is different. See, for example, simple like what we do is Manibandha Sukshmayam, very gently you can do, right? But Shakti Vikasaka Manibandha, what happens? Same thing you can do. But same thing, what is the feeling? If you just keep observing me, nothing will happen. If you do, then now, what is the difference now? This trying to touch here. So now what's happening? You can feel nice stretch, some activation, some channel, heart channel, it's moving, it's getting activated. So we can learn lot of things like this. We can just try to same, very simple Sukshma, but we can do it in a different way. Right, called Shakti Vikasaka, that we will see in one full session can be done on that also. Okay, and third is the totally opposite way in yoga. See, generally all in Chinese thing it's called yin and yang. In Hindu we call Ida Pingala. When you hold a pose like this, you are activating the muscle, the yang energy, the pingala energy gets activated. But the yin energy, the ida, the much deeper stresses, much deeper relaxation happens when you come to a pose and no muscle is active. And then you stay in a pose for long time. Like long time means like 3 minutes, 5 minutes. So there are many poses where you can allow to stay, which you can't, you are not holding any muscle. So like that, we will see some poses in yoga. So you come to a pose, simple, say Shashankasana. You come like leg spread, you just lie down and then you relax. Not sleeping, you relax and observing, then you see, you experience the effect of in yoga. Okay, then we do what is another thing called cyclic meditation. So in Mandukya Upanishad, one sutra is taken, where it says, see, for example, everybody would have done maybe or heard Yoga Nidra. Yoga Nidra is a very deep form of relaxation with awareness, right? But in Yoga Nidra, what happens? You are fully passive. So you go into one state and then the same deep state continues. But what happens in cyclic meditation? You first you relax. Then in the relaxed state, you do some little asanas. So you are activating the mind again. And then you allow it to relax. Then it will come down more. Then again you activate the body by simple asanas in meditative state. And then it comes down. So like that, it's called, that is, that's all the sutra says. You keep on, when the mind is going down, again you activate. When the mind is going down, again you activate. So when you keep doing, you get into a deeper, much more deeper state of awareness and relaxation. Both will happen. So it's called cyclic meditation. It goes for a long time, like 40-50 minutes, 1 hour process. So we'll see. So that is one more. And then one more yoga pose which I want to do is called hip openers. See, generally what happens, we always walk. The hip socket joint is like this, ball and socket joint. So this is the leg and this is the ball. But it can move. The socket can move in all directions. The hip can move in all directions. Right? But generally we walk only like this, only this movement. So because of it, what's happening? If you are not doing it, all the muscles here gets jammed surrounding the ball and socket. So we have to, there are a lot of asanas where we move the hip all around like that. Lot of asanas, easy, you can do one whole session on it. So we'll see hip openers, it's called. We'll analyze. So it will all happen 5 days, each day different sessions. But if you just keep watching this thing, oh, it's nice, then it's like, oh, going to the hotel, just reading the menu, oh, it's nice. But when will you feel? When you join, you will feel the experience of different things, so that then you continue your practice. Okay, so hope to see you in Explore Yoga 2. Jai Gurudev.